Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. In this video, I would like to explain another problem on Newton option method. See the statement of the given problem. Apply Newton option method to find a positive real root of the equation x into log x to the base 10 is equal to 1.2. Okay, this is a transcendental equation. See, first of all, let us represent the given equation with the f of x, which is equal to x into log x to the base 10 minus 1.2 is equal to 0. Always we have to express the given equation f of x is equal to 0 form. Take it equation number 1. So in Newton option method, we have to find out f dash of x. Okay. Take the derivative of f of x with respect to x. So you will get f dash of x now. So here, first term is x into log x to the base 10. Two terms are in product. That's why you should apply product rule in the derivatives, UV rule. So, derivative of the first function x is 1. 1 into log x to the base 10 is log x to the base 10. Plus, now u is similar term. So, x is similar term. We have to write out the derivative of log x to the base 10. Already we know that d by dx of log x to the base e is equal to 1 by x into log e to the base e. That's why it becomes 1 by x into 1. Everybody knows that log e to the base e is only 1. Okay. That's why derivative of log x to the base e is 1 by x. But here we have log x to the base 10. So d by dx of log x to the base 10 is equal to 1 by x into log e to the base 10. Okay. For log x to the base e, derivative is 1 by x into log e to the base e. In the similar way, derivative of log x to the base 10 is 1 by x into log e to the base 10. Okay, so write this derivative here. So 1 by x into log x log e to the base 10. So x getting cancelled. So f dash of x becomes log x to the base 10 plus log e to the base 10. That implies f dash of x can be written as first term is similar term log x to the base 10. Now I will write the value of log e to the base 10 by using scientific calculator. See, here we have log e means log e power 1. See, so log to the base 10 means you have to operate log, it is enough. So for e power you should operate shift ln power 1 and close the brackets, which is 0.43429. Okay, here 5th decimal place is 9, that's why 4th decimal can be taken as 3. So this value is nothing but 0.4343. Okay, this is f dash of x value. Now we have to investigate the initial approximations for required root of the given equation number 1. For that purpose, set the values, functioning values, from 1 onwards. Don't substitute x is equal to 0 when given equation contains log x to the base 10. Because if we put x is equal to 0 in this one, you will get log 0, which is undefined form. That's why start the values from 1 onwards. So 1 into log 1. So log 1 to the base 10 minus 1.2, which is equal to minus 1.2, because log 1 is 0, which is negative. And now calculate f of 2. F of 2 means whenever we have x in this given equation, replace it by 2. So you will get 2 times of log 2 to the base 10 minus 1.2. See the value in scientific calculator. See, 2 times of log 2, close the bracket, minus 1.2. is equal to, it is negative, minus 0.5979. again it is negative 0.5979 less than 0. So find out f of 3. So which is 3 into log 3 to the base 10 minus 1.2. See. So 3 times of log of 1.3, sorry, log 3, close the brackets, minus 1.2 is equal to, it is positive. So which is 0.2313, which is positive. So anyway, from these two functioning values, we observed that functioning value at 2 is negative, functioning value at 3 is positive. So initial approximations are 2 and 3. So by initial value theorem, we conclude that one of the root of given equation number 1 must lies between A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 3. Okay, 2 and 3 are known as initial approximations. Now, the algorithm in Newton Raphson method is xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn over f dash of xn for n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. With the help of this formula, we can easily find out the next better approximation for required root. Before finding the better approximations, we can find out f of xn and f dash of xn here. So xn plus 1 is equal to xn. What is f of xn? By using f of x, you will get f of xn, which is xn into log xn to the base 10 minus 1.2 over what is f dash of xn? In this f dash of x, replace x by xn. So you will get log xn to the base 10 plus 0.4343. Take the LCM. So log xn plus log xn to the base 10 plus 0.4343. Numerator becomes, it is 1, that's why xn into this term. Xn into log xn to the base 10 plus 0.4343 times of xn, and now split the terms for the second part, minus of xn into log xn plus 1.2. We are observing that this term getting cancelled because they were same but are of opposite signs. So anyway, you will get xn plus 1 is equal to 0.4343 of xn plus 1.2 is the remaining term in the numerator. So denominator is log xn to the base 10 plus 0.4343. This is Newton-Raphson algorithm for the given problem. Okay, you can take it equation number A. See. Now text editing, first approximation. We are going to find out first approximation now. For the first approximation, for the required roots, put n is equal to 0 in capital A. So you will get x suffix 0 plus 1, which is x1. So whenever we have n, we should replace it by 0. So you will get 0.4343 times of x0 plus 1.2 over log of x0 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. Okay, let us start with x0 as a plus b by 2. There are three methods to start the approximations which are, you may start with x naught as a, which is 2, otherwise you can take 3, otherwise you can start with a plus b by 2, no problem. So you will get 2 plus 3 by 2. So you can take x naught as 2.5. So x1 becomes 0.43 times of 2.5 plus, whenever we have x naught, replace it by 2.5, 1.2 over log of 2.5 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. Now let us calculate this one by using scientific calculator. Take this symbol directly. So what is the numerator? 0.4343, close the bracket and open the bracket, 2.5 plus 1.2, write the denominator. So log of 2.5 plus 0.4343, it is 2.7465. 2.7465. It is not necessary to find out functioning value at x1 in Newton option method. So take setting second approximation. So put n is equal to 1 in capital A, then you will get the x2, which is 0.4343. This time you will get x1 here, plus in previously you will get x naught, in this time you will get x1, plus 1.2 over log x1 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. Now replace the value of x1 which is obtained in the first approximation. So 0.4343 times of 2.7465 plus 1.2 over log of 2.7465 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. So again we will calculate this one by using scientific calculator. See, so 0.4343 of 2.7465, close the bracket, plus 1.2 and log of 2.7465 is the first part of the denominator, plus 0.4343 is the second part of the denominator, is equal to, you will get 2.7406. Now calculate third approximation. Put n is equal to 2 in capital A, you will get x3. So the formula becomes 0.4343 times of x2 now, plus 1.2. You can see equation number A and replace n is equal to, you will get this one. So denominator is log of x2 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. So recently we got the x2 value in the second approximation, replace it by 2.7406. So 4343 times of 2.7406 plus 1.2 over log of 2.7406 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. So by again using scientific calculator, see the calculations. 0.4343 times of 2.7406 plus 1.2, and the denominator is log of 2.7406, close the bracket, plus 0.4343. So you are getting, it is better to write only first four decimal places. So again you will get 2.7406. So we are getting two successive approximations are equal, second and third are equal. So you can take, you can take required root as 2.7406 approximately. So in this way we can find out the required root of the given equation. Thank you very much. In the next video I will give another example on Newton option method. Bye.